It begins with a department called Food and Beverage Service Management, where one has to go through a service field, where the service is again then divided into two, that's a service and then the bar. Mm-hmm. When you start working in a segment of a bar, then further it divides into a beverage server, mm-hmm. bartenders, then beverage supervisors, and then the position goes on. It's not an easy journey, I call it as, because a decade ago, this didn't require any skill to be behind working behind the bar.
Okay.
But now you need a lot of skill set to, you know, run the place, and the competition is too high to be into this particular profession.
Okay. So why do you think there's a sudden spurt in competition right now? It wasn't so before, you said. So why has this industry become so competitive of late?
If you see, Hima, the world is changing. The trends of eatery and drinkeries are changing.
Mm-hmm.
Quite in the days, I remember when I was a part of school, a night out or a party for me would be a cafe coffee day, going for a lovely cappuccino and Black Forest. But mm-hmm. lately, when the bars were only there back in five-star hotels and elite, mm-hmm. now the standalone is a new concept in the market, and a mm-hmm. lot of standalone with different concepts, theme restaurant, theme bars. Coffee shop, you know, tea specialty mm-hmm. houses. Brands like Shaken and Frozen Bottle. If you see mm-hmm. the beverage world, when it was limited to tea and coffee, what we had as a child, mm-hmm. or say like fresh lime soda or mango juices. Now, mm-hmm. if you go in the market, there is variety of things what you can experiment on as per your palate. Mm-hmm. I would be very happy to see this coming generation to, you know, coming to work behind a lot of concepts which we are creating, and they would be blessed to, you know, have it hand in hand, where mm-hmm. we struggled a lot to, you know, go thoroughly to understand it, cross exposure, mm-hmm. say, or probably, you know, pick up courses.
Mm-hmm.
The exposure would be, if one likes about water, he can be a water connoisseur. People love about grapes and the juices.
Mm-hmm.
It's not certainly that you have to come from certain background. Anyone can choose to be in this industry. There are a lot. You can be a tea master. You can be a coffee master. You can be a master for water. You can be a master for your wine, what you consume. You can mm-hmm. be master for your white spirits, brown spirits. If I keep talking, there are a lot of, you know, edible beverage available today in the market.
Mm-hmm.
One of the latest what people are very addicted and healthy way drinking is kombucha.
Mm-hmm.
You know, no one thought that, you know, just putting your leftover fruits into water, which naturally ferments. So there is a lot. You can say we closely work as a scientist, but there is no lab coats and labs and all. It's just your space. So it's fun. According to me, yeah, it's fun, and there is a lot of scope of working here.
Mm-hmm.
Lot of areas open up. Tomorrow you can be a R&D head. Tomorrow you can be a part of a product development company. Tomorrow you can. You can open up your own consultancy where you can consult the concepts to people.
Okay.
So yeah, I would say it's a very vast space of working.